Welcome to this stateless code video. This is video number 7 in our series Enough Inkscape to be Dangerous. And last time I was intending to do the logo for our statelesscode.com WordPress series that I completely got sidetracked and did a redesign of the overall stateless code logo. So that's kind of, we also did some stuff with the nerd dice die, kind of turning that into its own item. So, but this time we're actually going to do the stateless code, and WordPress logo. So I'll start here with the stateless logo transparent. I probably need to, I'll pause and create a directory for the WordPress stuff. All right, so we've got our directory. Now we'll save as pictures WordPress. We shall call this go. And now I'm going to import the WordPress logo. I want the logo only. Is ginormous. So let's make the height. Let's take out a 0. So no, I think I might like that. Let me see if I can put these on their own layer. Will actually below the current layer. Move this to WordPress. And then in this case, I'm going to see if I can get the opacity down to like 50%. There we go. And then I think I'm going to try to duplicate this six above, six below. I'll align them better in a minute. All right. So why is your opacity so much less than the other ones? So you're 50%, you're 50, you're supposed to be 50. Oh, and they all became 50. You're back to 100, it looks like. Oh, maybe move you all to the WordPress layer. You get the idea. I'll pause and finish this. All right, so I've got them all moved. I think I might have accidentally... Yeah, I changed the stateless code opacity to 50%. So that wants to stay 100%. Now we'll lock our logo and move to the WordPress layer here. So this one still... Change it back to 50 if we can. For some reason 50 just doesn't want to work the right way. This object, there we go. Now we've all got them. Okay, so I'm gonna do little bit. Let's get this to the, get them all to the Y that I want them at. Maybe 13. That doesn't look bad. I'll apply that to this row here. I wonder if there's a way with align and distribute to select all of these and distribute them. There we go. Now I'll do the same thing here. Make sure our X is the same on both of these. Your X is 8.642, so is yours. All right, let's playing with the opacity, I think I'm going to go with a little bit higher opacity here. So let's get back to all these. I'm going to go closer to 85. There we go. And then I'm going to create another layer. between those two layers. And this is where I'll import the WordPress the big logo. I'll try it. So, also ginormous. Let's lock the other two here. So my width, make this 120. Oh, now you're lost. Okay. And then I move this horizontally centered. And we're going to move it up the layer. Raise layer. Got that. Now I'm going to take the opacity of this and make it really low, like 25%. And we'll horizontal center on the vertical axis there. I kind of like that. So back to the lower WordPress layer. For some reason, I don't think the, this is still running at 45. I want it more like 85. That. The only problem is that this against the our blue background might be problematic, but give it a shot. So now I'm going to Alright, so I'm going to close this one out and open my stateless square. Inkscape SVG. save as. This logo, get rid of it. Import. The transparent version of this. And see how it does. What happens if I change the hue on the base here? I can't really flip it. I can't flip it 180 because that would be 53, which is the same color as the item there, but I go to my layer here. Let's play with this. Fill here. That is not our color. That's our color. So let's say I want to add 90 to that. That'll make 323. Too pink. If I maybe desaturate it some, we'll see. Actually, don't mind that. It's a little different than what we've got elsewhere, but I think this could work. Yeah, let's change it up a bit. gonna want a 2:1 version of this. I will use the nerd dice 2:1 as our basis for this. Save as. All right, so we'll go here. We'll in the logo area. Delete. Import. Larger. Let's make the height. /115. Horizontally and vertically center this, and then lock that, work on the background. And then I'm going to desaturate you. Take a look at how I did the other one. So I'm starting at 23, 50, 31, and then going to /25, /45, /50, /31, and then put this, I think I can come with maybe a little more lightness. Saturation. There. I think that works for our 2:1. Now it's time for a wallpaper. So start with our crashed. All right, we've gotten over our crash here. So let's start with our background layer. So I did the pink to blue by accident, but I think I want that. So here, I think I'm gonna eliminate. Oh, need to get back off of the. All right, let's go back to our layers. So we'll lock base now. I think we keep that. I'm going to, in layer one, I'm just going to get rid of the pink text. Then I'm going to logo, delete out the old one, oh, I better save as before I accidentally mess up my import our WordPress. I think I might go the blue and blue and pink on the at least the 2:1 as well. But we'll get this in here. Should make this much, much larger. Probably want to lock those. Okay, that's too big. See where that gets us. Still a little too tall. Now we're a little too short. The blue there. I think I want to do something about the I think it's all right. It's not, I mean, the contrast down below is pretty not the best in the world, but I think we'll take this. So I think we'll stop there. Thanks for watching this stateless code video. Be sure to like, comment, subscribe, and spread the word. Check out our growing library of videos on our social media channels. Follow us at Stateless Code, and taxation is theft.